Hello, my name's Steve. I'm an astronomer at Glasgow Science Centre, and welcome to Stargazing in Scotland, introducing you to the night sky from a Scottish perspective. Scotland really has some of the best dark skies for stargazing anywhere in Europe. So in this video, I'll introduce you to some of the equipment you might want to take with you when you go stargazing, even if you don't have access to a telescope. To find your way around the sky, it's really useful to use a map, just like you would use a map to find your way around an unknown town or city. You can download our Stargazing in Scotland pack for some simple star maps to get started with. Many star maps represent stars as circles, with brighter stars having larger circles. You might also find some stars joined up by lines. Now these aren't real, they're just imaginary. You don't see them in the real sky, but they show us the patterns of the constellations. Having these lines drawn on star maps often makes it easier to find things in the sky. When you're stargazing, you'll notice that the sky changes. If you're out for an hour or two, you'll see the stars appear to rise and set. That's because our planet Earth is spinning, and as we spin, everything appears to move around us. And over the course of a year, you'll see different stars visible in different seasons. There are constellations of stars visible in winter that you cannot see in summer, and therefore it's really important that your star map is up to date. Another option is to buy or make a planisphere. A planisphere is a star map with two pieces. One has a star map on the bottom, and on top of that is a rotating window that shows you what stars are visible when you're stargazing. Around the outside edge of the planisphere, you find dates and times. Just line those up for when you're stargazing, and the window will show you exactly what you can see. You can download and make your own planisphere using our Stargazing in Scotland pack. If you're using a map or a planisphere when stargazing, it's really important to keep your night vision as good as possible, and therefore don't use bright white torches. Use a red torch with dimmer light. That'll keep your night vision to help you see the stars better. There are also many great stargazing apps you can download for smartphones or tablets that help you explore the night sky. I use these all the time, and they are great for planning a stargazing trip. However, it's best not to use them when you're outside, because the screens can be incredibly bright, although many of them do have a nighttime setting, which can turn the screen dimmer and redder to protect your night vision. Now, many people, when they begin stargazing, want to jump straight in and buy a telescope, but for many reasons, a pair of binoculars might be a better first purchase. You might even have a pair of binoculars at home already. Sure, telescopes can give you a bigger and better and brighter view of the sky, but binoculars are easier to use. They're smaller and lighter to move around, and they're also significantly cheaper. Binoculars are essential if you want to take your stargazing to the next level. In general, the bigger, the better when it comes to binoculars. Larger binoculars give you a brighter, sharper, clearer image. But they're also heavier and more expensive, so you need to find the right pair of binoculars for you. Binoculars often have two numbers printed on them, for example, 10 by 50. The 10 by bit tells you how much they magnify the image, and the 50 bit tells you how big the lenses at the front are in millimeters. In general, the bigger the better, but 10 by 50s are great all-round binoculars. You might even have a pair in your house already. Astronomy binoculars tend to be a bit bigger. You might find a pair that are 15 by 70s, and they'll just give slightly bigger and sharper images. Using binoculars can be tricky, so get familiar with yours in daylight. Learn how to hold them and focus them so you're not doing that in the dark. You'll also notice when you're stargazing with binoculars, the images can be a bit wobbly, and that's because your hands shake. You just can't help it. The best views through binoculars are when you can keep them as still as possible. So perhaps try and balance them on something like a wall or an obliging friend, and that'll keep them still, giving you the best view possible. All of this kit is great, but don't worry if you don't have all of them. Download our Stargazing in Scotland pack for activities you could do yourself, and watch our other Stargazing in Scotland videos to find out what else you can see in the night skies. There's always something amazing to see in the skies above Scotland. So head outside next time it's clear and look up.